Nottingham Forest from afar looks another very, very difficult game. How do you assess it?
Yeah, when you look a bit closer, then it's still unbelievably difficult. So it's I liked a lot what they did in the summer with the transfers. So they added quality players. Also who fits to the philosophy of Karanka. So some really quality experienced players like Lewis Graben, for example. Some really quality players with Carvalho and something like this. So I think they're really highly motivated, also capable to fight for promotion, because it's an experienced side with high individual quality, and it worked out so far. They're in a good position. They are in the playoff ranks, and it's a tough place to go. Nearly each and every game in the championship level is tough, and we know so. Especially the next week or the next days are there with many, many high quality opponents, but. Yeah, we want to win points even in this game. So, and we know that we are capable to win against this quality team's points. So we were capable to win, for example, points in a tough place like Derby County as well. And for that, we won't drive and we won't travel to Nottingham and say, okay, let's not lose with too many goals. No, we want some points, and we're desperate to win some.
You did touch on the work they did in the summer in terms of the squad, and I think it's well known that obviously Mendes is maybe advising them. And do you see the parallels with Wolves last season? You know, some very, very, on the face of it, top quality Portuguese talent coming in. You can kind of see what they're trying to do and maybe emulate what Wolves did last season. Is that a fair comment?
Yeah, there are many similarities. And they try to go the same way with some quality players, especially some players with a Portuguese background, also meanwhile a possession-based side. Also the philosophy of Karanka fits to this. I think they have a clear vision, and then they want to go into this way, and they have a really quality side. And I'm full of respect. Yeah, I think we are also a side no one in the league likes to play against Norwich at the moment, because I can't remember one game during this season where the opponent was by far the better side. So I think each and every team is also respectful in order to face us. And that's what we want to bring on the pitch tomorrow as well. So we know that it's a tough place, but we also believe in our strengths and in our possibilities. And we know when we are there and bring our game, our philosophy on the pitch, we are competitive, and that's what we're trying to do tomorrow as well.
Round about this time here, maybe a little bit later on in the month, last season, where obviously you were on such an unbelievable run. We had the Arsenal game, and Derby came here, probably unjustly got the win that day, and then we all know that from there to Christmas, it was a very, very testing period. What gives you the confidence that, you know, that isn't likely to play out again this season? Do you feel the squad is a bit better? You've got some of the lads who were new to the league last season, they know what it's all about now. You've got more younger players in and around it. Do you think you've got the tools you need to ensure that it's not going to be that prolonged testing period?
Yeah, first of all, it's always fine margins, and there's no guarantee that this won't happen, because when there are many more injuries of some key players, so it could be difficult. But in general, I got the feeling perhaps you can compare our unbelievable good run in the recent season, in the last season, with our last one when we were there climbing up the table. But I got the feeling the level of performances was much better. So in the last season, we won many, many games with 1-0, with good defending behavior, sometimes even a bit lucky. And I got the feeling all the points we won in the recent weeks were pretty much deserved. And we were there with dominating the games. Even in the away games, we were there with really good performance. I think so in our development, we are a step further on. I also think we have the depth in our squad is even better than in the last season. So when I compare, for example, the options we have right now on the striker position, I made it clear. So several times it was really unbelievably tough to let, for example, Jordan Rhodes out of the team, or for example, Dennis Rubeni was not even in the squad in the last game. So I think the depth in our squad is a big strength as well in this season, and this is also important. And also the self-confidence. So I think we are right now pretty much settled in the way we want to play, in the way we want to dominate the games and in general. So I think even when there is sometimes a perhaps a setback. So we are much more settled in order not to struggle with belief in this philosophy or belief in the self-confidence we have. And so there's no guarantee so far, but I'm pretty sure that we are able to go further on in a really good way.
Busy period off the pitch. Yes. Contrast with three younger lads, Max and Louis and Jamal. But another piece of news, Steve Stone leaving his position as manager director. Your reaction on that, because we've not heard it yet, and just in terms of what you and the coaches and players do here at Colney, does it have any impact moving forward?
Yeah, first of all, I think brilliant news that we were able to give the three young lads long-term contracts, so it protects us, and it's also, yeah, big commitment that they 100%. There were some other options as well for them, because all the other clubs in the country are not blind. They are realizing that we have some really big talents, but that they commit to sign new contracts, long-term contracts. It's that they believe in our way, and that they believe in the way, in the direction we want to head. And I think, yeah, big compliment to Stuart Weber, to our board, to the leadership people in the of the club. So it was brilliant to be able to announce this contract. Also, I have just respectful and praising words for Steve Stone, because I think he was in a crucial role during a pretty important period for the club. And the financial pressure was unbelievably high, and perhaps the public didn't know how big the pressure was in the recent months. And he played also a pretty important part in order to solve the situation. And but it is professional football, and sometimes you have to accept that the ways head into a different direction, and he wants to search for a new task right now. And I think he was crucial, and we are pretty thankful that he was there. He was playing an important part in the last 2 years as well. Right now we replaced his role with a new structure. So I think a really, really good decision. But to be honest, it doesn't affect so much my work in the sporting side, because I worked before pretty close together with Stuart Weber. Steve Stone was more important then for the financial point of view and for the things behind the scenes. So it doesn't affect so much the sporting side. And so further on, we will work pretty close together with Stuart and the sporting side. So this new structure doesn't affect so much the first team. But in general, I think it's also that in this terms, the club's is heading into a good direction. Mm-hmm.